Every time people have to confess Christ in order to be saved. But after you're saved and after you're filled with the Holy Spirit, we have to realize that our walk with the Lord is a confession. In other words, whatever God has numerous promises that He has given, the scripture says all things are ours. He has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places. He has given us everything that pertains unto what? Life and unto godliness. Now we have tons of provisions that's legally ours, that's been legally provided us through the redemption of Christ. I mean, we are blessed with everything that we need in order for us to be victorious, in order for us to be successful, in order for us to be blessed. Those things have already been given to us, and they are legally ours.
Yes.
Amen. And the only way these things which are legally ours, how can they become ours in reality? We call it, how can they become vitally ours? See, there are two aspects of our redemption. There's the legal side, things that Christ has provided as a result of Christ's death, burial, and resurrection. Amen. Those are the legal aspects, the price that Christ paid, the things that He wrought for us, those 3 days and three nights. Amen. Those are legal rights that all of us, amen, have a right to. Amen. Those things are ours legally. Everybody just can lift your hands right now and just say, all things are mine. All things. All things are yours. You are blessed with every spiritual blessing. God has given you everything that pertains unto life and unto godliness. But many times you find out that very few of the provisions and blessings that Christ has provided us through His death and resurrection actually become ours in reality. Many times we don't experience the best that God has for us. Is that right? How many believe that you are absolutely experiencing the best that, amen, that God has for you? In every arena. Maybe I can just say in any arena. And I have found the main problem behind believers, the main problem is that I don't think we understand that our redemption, our walk with the Lord is actually called a confession. The Bible says, hold fast to your profession, which is, translated confession, without wavering. Our walk with the Lord is called a what? Confession. Profession. In other words, you're not going to get any more that's legally yours than you would claim. You confess. See, just like getting saved, you wouldn't have gotten saved unless you had a what? Agreed with God, unless you had a what? Said it with your mouth. After you had what? Believed it in your heart. You wouldn't have gotten saved. Hallelujah. You had to act. Right? And the first action that one takes after they believe is that you got to what? Come into agreement with what God says by what? Saying it with your mouth.
Yes.
The power of life and death is in your tongue. Bible says the mouth of the upright shall deliver you. Hallelujah! The mouth of the upright. And that is one area that I feel that most believers, and I can get the average one of you read any set of scriptures that I hand out. I can get any one of you almost to go through a meditation book that I have put together. You will go through there and read it. You will meditate it. You will what? Reflect on it. You look at it. You'll get happy over it. You'll rejoice over it. But to confess it or say it with your mouth, amen. I don't see too many people, amen, in prayer meetings, over in a corner, got those scriptures that they believe. They believe it because they have what? They've studied it, they've gone over it. of it is what? Just mental asset, and it's not really believing from your heart, because the Word of God doesn't become activated until you begin to what? Speak it out. You got to speak the Word of God out loud so that you can what? Hear. Faith comes by what? Hearing. How many can amen? Say amen. So if you really want to grow, if you really want to build yourselves up on your most holy faith, amen, you got to what? You got to pray in the Holy Ghost, and I believe also you got to what? Pray the Word in the Holy Ghost, and you got to learn how to what? Come into agreement and what? Say what God says, amen, and let it out in the form of a what? Of a prayer of affirmation or a confession. Amen. The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I fear?
Yes.
Glory. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
Yes.
Amen. Believers are a little slow. Turn to somebody and say, are you slow? To hook their mouths up with the Word of God. Be a little slow. We have to admit it and, amen, hallelujah. All right, how many admit that very seldom you listen to yourself say the Word? You don't talk to yourself in the Word. You read it, you meditate it, you reflect, but you look at it. Feel pretty good after you do it for 15 to 20 minutes. But that Word is not permitted to go deep down in your heart. Amen. Saying it is the thing that will release the power and the supernatural. Saying it. How did God speak? I mean, how did God get this world into existence as we see it today? He had to what? Speak it. He had to what? Use words. And I'm sure, you know, I've traveled to a lot of churches and be around a lot of ministries. And one thing you will not find, you don't find people praying in the Holy Spirit that much in some circles. You don't find them praying in the Holy Ghost. And I think that praying in the Holy Ghost is a powerful way of praying. How many believe that?
Amen.
Amen. But when it comes to praying in the Holy Ghost, most people say, no, I don't let nothing come out of my mouth. I don't know what I'm saying. And the scripture says, building up on your most holy faith by what? Praying in the Holy Ghost. And I think it's something to what? Hearing yourself pray in the Holy Ghost. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. But it's important for you to what? Confess. Now, what are you to confess? You are to confess. Now, this is the thing that we're speaking about today. How to expand your capability to believe. Okay? Now, how can we expand our ability to believe on a higher realm, on a higher level? And what I'm speaking to you today is that we have to understand the importance of what? Releasing words. God has made all types of provisions for us. Hallelujah. The scripture says that, amen, praise God, that we are complete in Him. The Bible says that we can do all things through who? Christ, that what? Strengthens. The scripture says, greater is He that is what? In me. Amen. Just lift your hands and greater is He that is in me. Now, that will never become reality to you. God in you is greater than your cares, your problem, your struggle, your ups and downs, whatever you're going through. God is in you to help you. Amen. Scripture says, casting all your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. Amen. He's there to assist you, to help. In fact, the Holy Ghost is called what? Amen. Our helper, our what? Intercessor, one that walks alongside of us, our comforter, our what? Guide. Hallelujah. And He's there to help. But, amen, the help that the Holy Spirit can release into our life is directly contingent upon you confessing the reality of Him. Amen. Praise God. Working on the inside of you. You gotta say, He effectually worketh in me. Christ is at work, working in me His will and ability are doing in my life.
Yes, yes.
You better open your mouth. And this is one of the most difficult struggles you have with believers, to get them to open their mouths. Somebody say, help us, Lord. So, those of you that still in that discussion, probably we might need to say, amen, believing is easier. Getting people to believe is a lot easier than getting people to what? To act. Now, when we say act on the Word of God, the first stage of our action is always what? Say what? Okay, if you are prayed for, and we say, Scripture says, whatsoever things you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them. Believe at the moment you release your faith. When I lay hands on you, that's the moment you are to what? Believe that you receive. In the spirit realm, in a spiritual form, you have God's word. God said it. Amen. The moment you release your faith and believe, at that instant, amen, you receive it in the spirit form. In other words, you have God's word for it.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's kind of hard for you to wrap your mind around that. People say, well, I don't feel nothing. I didn't see no lightning bolt. I didn't jerk. Well, God must not have done it. Bible says, well, believe that you received it. At the moment you were what? You were ministered to, or the moment you released your faith for that particular healing. Now, what are you to do the moment you release your faith? You said, yes, Lord, I agree. Amen. With your word. You said, if I would believe, amen, the moment I believe and I receive, I have it. So, Lord, thank you that I believe I am what? I am healed. I thank you that I believe that I am what? Healed. It's the same with finances. You come into agreement. My God shall supply all my need according to his riches and glory through Christ Jesus. And when you, at that moment, agree that Christ is your supplier, and he meets every need according to his riches in glory through Christ, the moment you agree that is so, amen, you release your faith, and you begin to say, Lord, I thank you that my needs are met according to your riches in glory. I believe that I have received in Jesus' name. Amen. How many understand that that is an action? That is what acting on the word of God. Agreeing with what God has said about whatever you are believing for. If God said whatsoever thing you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and ye shall what? Have. In other words, you can have what God says in two different forms. You can have it in a spirit form, or you can have, amen, and if you believe you have it in the spirit form, in other words, I have God's word for it, then it's going to manifest in a what? Material form. I'm going to show you that the most trustworthy person I know in the whole world is my wife. Amen. She got a message for me too. All right. She got a message for me. I got a message for her. She's probably the most trustworthy person. And if she tell me a rooster dips snuff, I'll go look under his wings, and I'll be looking for a snuff box somewhere. And she told me that a rooster dips snuff, because her word is just that reliable as far as I'm concerned. Now, if she called me on the phone and told me that, honey, I just drew out $100, and that $100 is yours, I'm bringing it home. I know you have a need of $100. All right, now I have her word for that. Do I have it in the realm of my faith, the realm of her word? How many believe that, you know, God's word will never what? God won't lie. My wife never lies. She wouldn't tell me a lie. So I have as much word, I mean, just like God's word, when she tells me that I have $100. So as far as I'm concerned, I already have it in my spirit already. It's already settled. Is that right? It's already settled. What do I do? Thank God. Amen. Praise God. My need has been what? Met according to your riches, Lord. Thank you. I begin to what? Praise God. I begin to what? Rejoice. I don't have no ifs, ands, and maybes about that, because I know her word is good. And amen. And the Bible said, let us hold fast to our confession of faith without what? Wavering. Whenever God promises you something, you what? Amen. You receive it the moment you release your faith. And you begin to what? Thank God and rejoice that that thing you're believing for is already what? Yours. And as you begin to rejoice, as you begin to praise God, amen, praise, and as you begin to praise God, see, hallelujah, the end result of the thing you are believing for, that thing is going to what? Manifest in your life in a material form. How many can say amen? So you can believe, amen, that you have it in the spirit realm, and you can believe that you, amen, and that's the thing that's going to make it what manifest in the what, natural realm.
Yes.
How do I understand the example of Sister Hill, $100 blessing? How do I understand that?
Yes.
All right, so, amen. I'm ready for that $100. But I don't have no basis for that believing her, because she ain't what? She ain't gave me no what? Promise. You gotta have a what? A basis for believing. You just say arbitrarily what? Believe something and what? Amen. Say, God is gonna do this. I believe I receive. Believing gotta be based on what? The word of God.
Yes.
How many can say amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise God. All right. So that's it. In other words, she wants me to wrap this up. All right. But I just want you to understand that believing is the area that most times, if we receive enough information, we're going to have enough information to act on the word if we will decide to what? To act. And the first action we need to take is what? We need to what? Agree with God. If God says it, He's the strength of your life.
Yeah.
Your life. He's the light of your salvation. You, yeah. Whatever God says about you, you need to what? Open your mouth and what? Say what God says.
Yeah.
Amen. With the heart, everybody just say with the heart.
With the heart.
Man believeth. Unto righteousness. But with the mouth. Say it with the mouth. Say it again. With the mouth.
With the mouth.
With the mouth.
Confession is made
unto salvation. In other words, before your deliverance will manifest, you got to what? You got to what? Release words. There's power. The power of life and death is in your what? Tongue. The mouth of the upright shall what? Deliver them. So you have to what? Speak things into existence after you have what? Believe that you have received. You got to what? Say it with your mouth. Everybody say amen.
Everybody.